guys, what is going on? It is Obadiah, and today we are back on the island playing some Extinction Core Arc. So today, I thought a lot about what I want to do today. Oh, by the way, if you guys do enjoy these videos, or if you learned something, do me a favor and hit that thumbs up button. Of course, feel free to subscribe and share. So I've been thinking a lot about what I want to do today. I've been trying to get streaming to work. Oh, my Mosasaurus, get over here. He was on top of my roof, and now he's over here. Did something hit him? Are you okay, little Mosasaurus buddy? You're on aggressive. That is not the ideal situation. Passive, how about that? Okay, let's put you somewhere else. Over here by the trough, maybe. Come on. Just wake up, let's go. So I've been thinking about a lot what I want to do today. And I think I want to go kind of see what we can tame. We've tamed a lot of what like we really want to tame that we have kibble for. But there's still a lot we don't have kibble for. And also, Extinction Core, the mod, was just updated. Oh man, this guy's freaking slow when he's tired. Kind of like me. Also, since the mod updated, they changed the cost to make the boss saddles. And so while I was like super, super close to making the dragon saddle, now I'm not, because now I need a bunch of fire talents, which you get from wyverns. What are you doing in here? Come here, Compy, where to go? Yeah. How's that feel? Anything else? Okay. So I want to kind of go out and kill fire wyverns, I guess, because I need 10 of the talons to make the frigging saddle now, which is insane. Oh wait, I don't even know if I have everything I need. What do I even have? I didn't even check. Okay, so blood vials, good. Detox is good. Sedatives, good. Darts, arrows, all my gear, some food, some water, all this crap. This just happens to be in there, and let's grab all of the kibble we have, in case we run into something good. So hopefully we can find something really cool to tame, but also hopefully we'll find a bunch of good fire wyverns to kill, or any wyverns, so we're gonna need all the talons. So I'm gonna go ahead and look around, see what we can find, and then I'll bring you guys back. Oh, check it out, it's one of those cool firebird things. Oh, I don't think we have any kibble to tame it with. They take Archaeopteryx kibble? What is eating me? What? Who dares attack me? Oh, it's only level 20? Is that what it said? Oh, is it attacking me now too? Yeah, it's only level 20, so it's no big deal, so we'll probably just kill it. And hopefully another one will respawn. I did see another one, so I think they're starting to respawn now. Okay, let's just do some of this. All right, I'm sorry. I know I'm a terrible person. Firebird has been defeated. So I do definitely want to tame one of those guys in the future, but that guy was low and I don't have the kibble anyway, so I'm just gonna leave him there. Might as well let another one respawn. But very cool, because those guys are super rare. I mean, I think the spawns are getting fixed and whatnot now, but I didn't see one for a really long time. All right, guys, here's something I really want to do. There's a Giga right there. A wild Giga, level 8, so not really worth taming. But I want to see how hard it is to kill it with this Rex. I've never killed a wild Giga like this. I mean, I assume it won't be that hard because we got crazy armor. And oh, it's raging! Oh, it has this crazy slowdown effect. Look at this. You going down, sucker? Oh, yeah. Oh, this is like nothing. And it's dead! I've always wanted to kill a wild Giga, and now I did, and now I'm falling to my death! Ooh. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and keep looking, but I just wanted to show you guys that, because I've been waiting to run into one of those guys so we can go head-to-head! Oh, also, if you see I have the stat FPS thing running in the right, that's because I've been having some weird graphic stuff going on the last couple days. So I have that up there so we can kind of monitor it. I'm getting like 80 frames per second right now, so it shouldn't be any issues. But it's the worst when, like, there's something going on and I don't realize it, and then I'm recording, and then I go to edit, and I'm like, oh, why is all the footage all glitchy and crap? And then, you know, I just said, bleh. So, anyways, I'm monitoring it now, so if you see that, that's why. And holy crap, I was just out here killing, and there's a giant bug right here. Okay, first, let's whistle passive. Didn't work. Okay, passive. Can we knock it out? Ooh. Are these tameable? Because if they are, I need it. No, I said passive. Come on. Okay, that definitely hit. Kong, go to sleep. Oh my gosh, I want to tame this bug. Prime Titan Minirna. Oh, hey, there's the bag I was looking for. I just killed another one of those firebirds. Oh, what do we got? Nothing. Okay. It was also like a super low level, like level 12. I have a feeling this guy's not knockoutable. Because if he was, he would have got asleep. I mean, these little darts are pretty dang powerful. And look at him. He's like stuck full of darts now. Killing me here, bud. All right, we'll try another shot. No, they keep not registering. Okay, we're just gonna sit right here. Nope. Register! This is it. This is the one. Okay, yeah, it definitely looks like they're not. Let's see, can we see like their topor? Topor is, it looks like it said zero. Yeah, so they can't be too. Ooh, Trapman! All right, guys, we are back at base, and that was a huge, massive failure. Didn't find anything super amazing and awesome to tame. So instead, I think that we are going to try and craft a bit of stuff and maybe do a bit of breeding. Should we do the breeding first? What do you think? What do you think, Alpha T-Rex? I hear battle music. Is it Compy? Stop. This is like the third time in a row Compy's spawned in my base. Is there another one? Oh. Really? You're attacking my house? There we go. All right. So, we got some stuff. And there's a couple things I want to try out. First off, where's the blueprints? We got blueprints for prime stuff. Now, you get these from killing bosses. And what the prime stuff is armor that doesn't break, which is amazing. So we have things for prime flak. We got, let's see, do we have the full set? Head, chest, gloves, pants, boots. We have a full set. We have two boots. We can drop one of those. Yes. We've got riot. We have two chests. We can drop one. We have got chitin, which I think is actually what we're going to make. Let me tell you why. So let's look at the flak for a second. With the prime flak, here's what the, let's look at the chest. 130 black pearls. Then hide, fiber, ruby, flak, whatever. Here's the problem. 130 black pearls is a lot of money. Here's how many pearls we have. About 1,500. And I think that's it, right? Yes, about 1,500. But each boss saddle cost 500, and so we don't want to box is flying around, use all our pearls, which is super bummer. So let's look at riot. Now the riot, here's the riot chest piece, takes 400 black pearls, but the chitin stuff takes no black pearls, and it takes prime hide, then prime chitin and keratin, which we have a lot of. How much do we actually have? Do we have any in here? Let's take a look. Okay. Let's go. I think it might all be in the workbench. Yeah. We've got a bunch. And I'm sure. Can you get out of the way, really, Quetzal? Look at that. 5, 10, 15, 20, 2,500 and something. Stack these because organization's important. That's 2,581. And you know what? That can get us quite a bit. So the deal with the prime stuff is also has double the armor and it's unbreakable. So I think chitin really might be the way to go. We also have been picking up some prime pieces of armor from the new alpha. That's the wrong thing. That's also the wrong thing. From the new alpha tribesmen. And I'm wondering if we can actually break this stuff down. So let's see. Okay, that's flak. So we got boots, head, two fur chest piece, and two fur gloves. And I'm wondering, if we put it in the grinder, we should get some materials back. But I wonder if we'll get more from the workbench. So let's grab one of the blueprints and take a look. Okay, blueprints. Let's go prime fur. Oh, we only have the blueprint for the chest. Okay. So, let's break down the chest here and salvage it and see what we get. Oh, that makes me so nervous. Let's do the gauntlets first. Attempt salvage. Okay, so we do get prime pelt back. Oh, and we got the fur gauntlets back and some other stuff. Okay. So let's try the chest piece then. Nice. And then we'll salvage that. Oh yeah, it's all sorts of good stuff. Look at that, there are 50 pearls. So that might be a really great way to get some prime pelt and whatnot before we were having trouble getting. Oh, awesome. So any extra pieces we get is what we'll do, because we don't need more than one because it's unbreakable. Put that in there, that, and we'll put all this stuff elsewhere. Awesome. So, that's an exciting little thing. So we have to go out and do some more farming, but for now, let's do this prime chitin stuff, I think. So let's go boots, chest, gloves, helmet, and gauntlets. And let's see what else. Can you really? Okay, you gotta move, because we're gonna be running back and forth a bit, and your big old head's all up in the way. All right, so let's make this happen. There we go, nice and clear. Let's throw this stuff in there and see what we need. So all we need is actual chitin armor, which of course we've thrown away thousands and thousands of it. I don't know if we have any. C. H. Nope. Okay, so we're gonna have to make some. But that's no big deal. Do we make it in our inventory, or do we make it in the... I guess we make it in the, whatchamacallit there. Okay, let's take some of that. Take some of that. Take some of that. Probably, I'm guessing we need some fiber. Probably some hide. Okay. Throw it all in the smithy. Let's just transfer all. C-H-I. Chitin. So we'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, now we can throw this stuff in here. Let's see what it takes. Okay. And I think we have some more chitin and whatnot and hide and stuff. Let's craft the boots. Let's craft the chest. This. So now let's go ahead and throw this stuff in the upgrade bench and see what we can do. What is it going to take to upgrade? Chitin, hide, fiber, sapphire. Oh, we need to make more chitins. Oh, dear. This is might be a little more of pain than I originally thought. So I think I vastly... underestimated how many materials it would take to make this thing. I made a ton of the chest pieces and the legs and the whatevers and the all the chitin regular stuff. And so far I've been able to upgrade the helmet to epic and the boots to rare. And even now, it's like, you need a ton more prime chitin keratin. But at least now we have a purpose for it. So we're going to keep working on this as we get more chitin keratin and keep trying to upgrade stuff and upgrade and upgrade and upgrade. But it seems like that's all we can do right now. So... I have in my possession fertilized alpha eggs from our guys. I've got two of them now. The timer is really long, but I think we do want to hatch these suckers. Originally, we were going to give these eggs to people, but the people we were going to give them to, or the guy we were going to give one to, at least hasn't been on for like a week. And so, sorry, bud, but we're just going to hatch. And if we get more females, then we can make more eggs and start just giving them to everybody. So we're going to go ahead and hatch those. I also have a Quetzal egg in here, which I think we might work on hatching for the last Quetzal egg. And I think we're going to get one more of those. We might also breed sabers. Let's go ahead and just take a look. What do we have? Let's take our little Dimorphodon buddy back. Okay. Nope. Better idea. Let's take the Quetzal back, because that's what we actually want to breed. And we're also going to check the timer on the other Rex, see how long before we can get another egg. Let's see. Open. The automatic door thing with the structures plus is really cool and almost not functional at all, unfortunately. Can we just land up on top of the little landing fly shelf thing that I've made? There we go. Awesome. So this is the male. So this is the female. So they're good. And this is the female. And I believe you still have a couple days left. But yeah, 2 days left before you can breed. All right, so we will enable wandering, and we will enable wandering, and we're going to go ahead and watch this one, because it is the female, and let these guys breed, and then we're also going to get an egg from the sabers, or not an egg, but going to impregnate a saber, and then I'll bring you guys back. All right, so we've got our eggs laid down. We've got two Quetzals, two Alpha Rex, and this Saber is about to give us her baby. Oh, you see how pregnant she is. Very, very much so. All right. So, how long is this going to take? Did I start doing this too early? We don't want to sit here and wait for like an hour and a half while this sucker pops out. We got meat on us. I was going to use the baby food, but then I looked to see what it takes to make it. And it's, let's look quick. It takes raw fish for the carnivore baby food. And I just wasn't about to go and get a bunch of that right now. So, here we go. Where is it? Alpha Baby Sabertooth has been summoned. Where are you? What? There you are. Oh, you're flying. Except... meat, disable wandering, and get more meat. All right, both of the Alpha Rexes just hatched. Holy crap, but I almost missed it. Okay, grab him. Oh, jeez, I couldn't hit record in time. I stepped away for 1 second. And then all of a sudden I have two baby Rexes popping up everywhere. Okay, whew, just barely avoided that. All right, disable. Sweet, so what do we get? Females, one male, and a female. Awesome, so now we can start breeding twice as fast for anybody else who wants the eggs. Let's get these suckers outside before they get too big. And then, why is the volume so low? There we go. There it is. Okay, now come on out. Okay, let's put them on low. So both our male and our female adults right now have the exact same stats, so we know what we're gonna get, which is great. That's why they're all gonna come out level 131. They're all going to look exactly like this because, of course, they had to breed out with the ugliest possible colors ever. That's what our breeding pair has. But sweet, now we have two more, and these would be great guys just to have as backups, since now we have a second, essentially an entire breeding pair. All right, any second now, the first Quetzal egg should hatch. The other one shouldn't be too far behind. Hopefully we get something super awesome. We're looking for hopefully above level 150, because I think its parents before leveled are 149 and something else. I don't know, but this one should come out. We have a chance of it coming out pretty good. I didn't really check too much on the stats. I'm having screenshotted, but I can look into all that later. Come on, are you gonna pop or what? You gonna hatch? Any second. There it is, 157. All right, that doesn't seem that bad. Go ahead and disable wandering, throw on some meat, and let's get this sucker outside. And just about now, there should be an imprint ready on the Rexes. I've done maybe three or so on each. Oh, forgot how slow baby Quetzals are. All right, the next Quetzal egg should pop up any second here, and then we should be good to go. Oh, I should need to check the imprinting times, too. I totally forgot. I didn't look at the one on the, gamma is really high. On the, it popped! On the Quetzal yet. Okay, throw some meat on. Disable warning. We'll get this sucker outside. And then, we're gonna keep imprinting for a little bit. And then we should be good to go with a bunch of new dinos. All right, guys, we have done a bunch of imprinting, so we got this Rex... 39%, this one also 39, and then the Quetzals are at what, 11 13, somewhere around there. Yeah, 11 and 13. So we did quite a bit, and at this point I am tired. I don't want to sit around here anymore and do that, so for today that is going to be it. If you guys do enjoy the video, if you learned something, do me a favor and hit that thumbs up button. And of course, always feel free to subscribe and share if you have not done so already. I really do appreciate you guys coming to hang out with me. You can also check me out on all your social medias, your Twitter, your Instagram, your Facebook, or even your Google Plus. And check out my Patreon at patreon.com/obadiahx. Before today, guys, like I said, that is going to be it. I do appreciate you coming to hang out with me. And until next time, I will see you later.